Hi students, in this video we are going to learn about the optical isomerism in complexes of coordination number 4. Before studying optical isomerism in complexes, first we have to know what is optical activity. It is very important to study optical activity before optical isomerism in complexes. Here is a source of light. You may take the example of bulb. This has electromagnetic waves vibrating in all the direction. This light scatters in all the direction like this. This may scatter like this in all around all the directions. This may scatter and this has electromagnetic waves which are vibrating in all the direction like this. When the Nicol prism is placed in front of this type of light, we will obtain a plane polarized light. This plane polarized light which vibrates in only one direction. Only one direction it is vibrating. It is the plane polarized light. Such type of lights which vibrates in only one direction, it is called as plane polarized light. Here the solution of complex under study is taken in the polarimeter. If the solution of the complex under study rotates the plane of polarized light towards the right side or towards the clockwise direction, it is called as dextrorotatory or also it is called as deform. It is indicated by positive sign before name of its formula. And if the solution of the complex rotates the plane of polarized light towards the left side or in the anti-clockwise direction, it is called as levorotatory or L form. It is indicated by minus sign before its name of the formula. It is about the optical activity. If such compounds which rotate the plane of polarized light, which can rotate the plane of polarized light, is called as optical activity. By this explanation, we came to know that such complexes which can rotate the plane of polarized light are said to be optical active. If the complexes rotate the plane of polarized light towards the left or right side, they are said to be optically active. And this property possessed by the complex is called as optical activity. Here are the important conditions for a molecule to show optical isomerism. I'll say it one by one. First, the most necessary and sufficient conditions for a molecule to show optical isomerism, that means to exist in the D and L forms, are as follows. We already know that what are D and L forms. The most necessary and sufficient conditions are explained here. First, the molecule should be asymmetric. The molecule should be asymmetric. That means a molecule should not have a plane of symmetry. It should not have a plane of symmetry. Here asymmetric means the groups around the central metal atom or ion should be different. That means in the tetrahedral complexes, four different ligands should be different around the central metal atom or ion. Now to explain plane of symmetry, I have taken this as examples. Here consider a square here. Here draw an imaginary line that divides this molecule. Consider it as a coordination complex. Draw an imaginary line which divides the molecule into two arcs, and it is one first arc, it is the second arc. Here you can see this imaginary line has cut the molecule into two equal parts. Here you can observe that this structure is a mirror image of this structure. It is the mirror image of this first structure. First structure is mirror image of the second structure. Now it is defined as the imaginary plane, imaginary line which divides the molecule in such a way that part of it on one side of a plane is a mirror image of the other side. If the molecule has plane of symmetry, then it is said to be optically inactive. Now consider the second structure. Here you can draw the imaginary plane that cuts the molecule into two halves. This is one half and it is second one. Here you can observe that this first image is not the mirror image of the second one, so it is not having no plane of symmetry, so it is called as, it is said to be optically active. Such type of complexes which do not have plane of symmetry are said to be optically active. Such type of complexes which have plane of symmetry are said to be optically inactive. And the second important point here is the molecule should not be superimposed, that is superimposable on its mirror image. When the molecule is cut into two halves, the two structure should not be superimposable. It is the second point. The molecule should not be superimposable on its mirror image. Its image and its mirror image should not be same. It should be non-superimposable to its mirror image. Then it is said to be having optical activity. They are said to be optical isomers and they can be exist in the D and L forms. These are the conditions for a molecule to show optical isomerism. Now we can start our explanation about optical isomerism in four coordinated complexes. Four coordinated complexes compounds have two types of geometries, that is tetrahedral and square planar complexes geometry. Here it is the tetrahedral molecular geometry and it is square planar. In the tetrahedral, you can observe that this ligand is present on the back side, this is on the front side, that means it is on the wedge line, that means it is front side. This dash shape shows that it is on the away from the observer, and this line shows that it is on the plane of the paper. Here in the square planar structure, these two are towards front and these two are away from the observer. Now optical isomerism four coordinated compounds. No, here no mirror image isomers. We can call it as mirror image isomers also. It is also called as optical isomers also. No mirror image isomers are possible with the tetrahedral and square planar complexes of type MA4, MA3B, MAB3. This type of complexes cannot exhibit optical isomerism. That is because all the ligands around the central metal ion are exactly equivalent. The possible, we'll write the reason here, because all the possible arrangements of the ligand around the central metal ion are exactly equivalent. So it cannot exhibit optical isomerism. The complexes are MA4, MA3B, MAB3 cannot exhibit optical isomerism in the tetrahedral and square planar geometry. Now we can study optical isomerism in tetrahedral complexes. We have already know that the complexes of type MA4, MA3B, MAB3 cannot exhibit optical isomerism. Now the complex of type MABCD can exhibit two optical isomers. See, it is MABCD. It is the tetrahedral geometry. Here is a metal ion and around it ligands are situated. Here is A, here is B, here is C, here is D. When the mirror is placed here, it is a mirror image. Here A is same. In the place of D, B has came. C in the place of B, D is there and C is same. These are the two optical isomers. Why these are called as optical isomers means it has no plane of symmetry. That means imaginary line, if we draw the imaginary line like this, which divides the molecule into two halves, one image is not the mirror image of the other. So it is not having any plane of symmetry. So it is asymmetric. This cannot be superimposed on this. If you place this molecule on this side, on this upon this, we place this molecule on this, we cannot superimpose these two molecules. A will be here, upon A and D will be upon B, B will be upon D and C will be upon C. They cannot be exactly superimposed on one another. That is, they cannot be superimposed on one another. So, it is optically active. So, these are the two optical isomers of the tetrahedral complexes of MABCD type. Why this complex MABCD type has a optical isomerism means it has no plane of symmetry, it is asymmetric, they cannot be superimposed on one another. Here this is the example of the complex MABCD. It is AS CH3 C2H5 S C6 H4 COO 2 plus. In this type of complex it exhibits optical isomerism. It is a tetrahedral geometry. Here you can observe that it is AS, here is CH3, C2H5, S, C6H4, COO, S, here C2H5, and this side on the CH3 side it has C2H5, on the C2H5 side it has CH3, C6H4, COO, minus. This complex is said to be optically active and it has optical isomers because it does not have a plane of symmetry, it is asymmetric molecule, that means it contains all the different ligands, it cannot be superimposed on its mirror image. So this complex of type MABCD is having optical isomers. We have studied optical isomerism in tetrahedral complexes, now we can study in the square planar complexes. Optical isomerism rarely occurs in the square planar complexes because all the four ligands are on the central metal ion or in the same plane. That means they have plane of symmetry. If all the different ligands present means also they have plane of symmetry. That is why they are optically inactive. So they cannot show optical isomerism. But a square planar complex having optical isomerism was prepared by Mills and Quibell. This is the complex, that is isobutylene diamine meso stilben diamine platinum 2 cation. It was prepared by Mills and Quibell. This is a square planar complex which exhibit optical isomerism. But this complex is prepared by Mills and Quibell is showing optical isomerism in square planar complexes. This is the example for square planar complex optical isomerism. This is about the optical isomerism in the coordination compounds having coordination number 4.